an old version of me that I have to state. This, literally, I have to say, it's kind of a story behind, but I'm going to present this to you like this. I'm going to, like, literally make this short, but I'm going to tell you why I used to love anime, why I used to love literally getting lost and being shipped out, literally, because why I love literally Tintin and why I love, you know, Naruto's fan base as a whole. You don't understand. Naruto was literally what inspired me to do so much shit because literally, like, I was literally playing Ultimate Ninja on the PS2, literally watching Naruto AMVs. That is what I mean by living through anime. People think that literally, like, yo, I use this anime shit, you know, as inspiration for everything. No, I was just a little kid growing up. I thought it was the coolest thing ever. But freaking, when I started watching AMVs and shit like that, that's when I found friends like Peter who thought that they were meaningless. The shit that they, like, literally came with, like, literally had nothing to do, but I understand why it's bad. You don't want to watch something like AMVs that make you feel heavily romantic and you not have a girlfriend. It's like, never, never, ever make that mistake. I've made that mistake, and it really, really hurts. Like, you can be in your own little world watching, like, literally, this AMV, love it, get bored. Comes to gig, another person's approval. Oh my god, don't even get me started. You have to understand that, literally, fucking, this is a shipping that literally makes you think everything about Naruto, how great Naruto is. It has nothing to do with the romance. It's just the similarities between their powers and, like, literally. So you already know, like, there are fan shippings called, like, you know, like, Neji Ten, you know, Naohina. Those are, like, shit. Yeah, I'm that big of a weeb. I've been watching anime ever since I was, literally, in junior high. So you have to understand, like, literally, I was all about watching those trailers. Like, I watched anime movie trailers. You don't even know about that. Like, literally. And that's why I got the idea of mood tunes, was literally watching anime trailers, literally watching how people air videos for anime. But you gotta understand, this is all taking somebody else's shit at the end of the day. People fail to realize that concept. That's why so many people who make AMVs, so many people end up in the mental hospital because, literally, how much it puts you in your own little world. It really, really is tragic. You need to let this aspect go. You need to understand why it's good, but you can't, like, literally get inside this world and literally be so absorbed with it. Everybody was talking about 300, and I stay at my home and I watch the fucking visual version of Sonic 06. I didn't even play the fucking game, literally. My family went to go watch Iron Man 300, and I skipped it just to watch fucking videos online, literally. That's not, like, in actuality, like, in terms of, that's not healthy because of evolution. Today, that'll be cool because people are intellectuals and they know that, like, fucking 300 is a whole bunch of toxic masculinity. But fucking back then, it's not cool at all. You have to understand. Back then, at the time, literally, because it's not being aware of your environment. You're neglecting your environment in order to stay in your own little world. Where everybody's talking about 300, you know how insecure I was growing up, literally. They're talking about some badass people killing people, literally this and that. I'm sitting over here watching anime shit, watching literally, you know what my brother calls that? You know what so many people call that? They call that faggot shit. Like, you watching, like, literally two anime characters, like, literally, that aren't even scripted together, going together. You're making fan shit and stuff like that is gay as fuck. It's not. It's the exact opposite, but you gotta understand, the community is, like, literally what supports that. I don't see anybody fan shipping that I know of that literally hasn't not hit the bumpy road. Fan shipping is literally, that shit is very troublesome. And I don't know any other black person that literally fan ships. I have no idea because that's literally how rare it is. It's one thing to be a fucking weeb and be all about anime analytically and fucking, you know, make debates about the shit, make theories, but it's a way another thing to have the soul of an AMV maker who literally freaking, you know, his friends are only in their anime, like, very, very sheltered and shit. Like, literally, you have to go all out when it comes to that because we all have the same amount of clips. And AMVs really, 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 really teach you how much of an intellectual you are. But why it's literally so subjective to just one thing. And it's really, really got to keep you with one thing. It's really fucking horrible. And as I grew older, I'm like, these concepts are amazing. But what if anime was social? These concepts would be really, really hot, but because they're not benefiting you, you have to understand, you have to learn how to gain benefits from a situation. You can't just be in your own little world. It's really, really not good at all. I'm telling you, it doesn't matter. I'm getting like that. If you want to know how the other side feels, it does matter because, literally, what that is like, literally, don't think the other side is, like, equal or equivalent. What the other side is, the other side is a tool. Like, say, literally, you have a shitty life, but you get to go to a party every once in a while. That's just a fucking tool. That's to help cope with, like, literally, like, fucking... But if you literally are left with no fucking tools and the other person at least has resources, yeah, people don't like him for who he is and shit like that, but at least he can, like, relieve some stress by literally going out and literally expressing himself a little bit instead of somebody who's just cooped up literally to a screen all day. You have to understand that. I learned that after being a celebrity, after being a hood rap star. I'm like, dude, I would rather, you know, just if we can go back to the old days where I'm in my own little world, but then I'll never get girls, and then I'll never get, like, anything that, like, keeps me insane. That shit keeps me intact. Me fucking all those girls, me, like, literally, and having friends who like me, who I am, that just keeps me intact, like, literally. What I really want is I really want to do activities. I really want, like, to really go far with them and, like, literally do shit with them, you know, instead of it being on this basis. I understand, like, the other shit was getting in the way, but you have to understand, like, literally, that's the whole concept of it. A lot of people live the life that I'm living now, the oxymoron, you know, besides the fucking girls and shit, but a lot of people, like, live that oxymoron lifestyle, and really, they're rolling for it instead of striving for something better. You just don't want to, like, be wasting time with people your entire life, but you definitely don't want to, like, literally try to get to know people at all, think you know everything, and then people fucking correct you, and then when you go older like me, what happens is you realize that they didn't correct you, you were ahead of the time, but what the fuck does that change about the situation? I knew anime was hot, but literally, it took the world from fucking so fucking long, fucking wait till Fire Force comes out to validate anime, where they could have validated it when we had Soul Eater. Sorry, that's how this world is. It takes My Hero Academia to catch niggas' attention when Dragon Ball Z was too fucking hot. Literally, you have to understand that. We have to turn anime to fucking superheroes in order for Americans to understand it. Fuck out, man. But this is literally a tribute to what this is. What this is gonna completely blow your mind. Since anime is the regular now, you get to absorb it as an anime fan. This is the life I was living back when I was in 7th grade. Pretty cool, right? But now anime is so. Imagine being the same, like, anime fan, having the same amount of hype in your head, like, literally, this and that. This is going to make you feel so good as an anime fan, but imagine if you had no friends and you got stuck in this own world forever. Literally. So I want you to watch this. I want you to see if you are sane after watching both of this shit.
Nobody wants to be alone. Does he make you cry? Does he know the way you feel? Love is all around you. Your universe is full. But in my world, you make me high. You make me real. You make me cry. Now you know the way I feel.
John Tucker. He is the man. Captain of the basketball team. He lost it to the homecoming queen and the prom queen at the same time.
I'll keep you my dirty little secret.
Les hommes ont grillé.
You are so sexy when you speak French.
He's got two girlfriends. Whoa, scratch that. Three girlfriends?
Have you ever dated John Tucker?
Hey, he's mine. Stay away from me. I'm dating John Tucker.
This guy is cheating on all of you, and you're beating each other?
We have something in common.
We all want to kill John Tucker.
What are you girls up to?
Destroying a man.
All right. Play nice, girl.
Your mom is so hot.
If we combine all of us, we can make him fall in love with you, and we'll yank it all out from under him.
Who's the new cheerleader?
She's not into high school boys.
I'm obligated to buy you dinner. I'm captain of the team. You're our new cheerleader.
You just enjoy the most amazing girl in school.
Can I hear you at home?
Hi. What do I do?
Are you a good kisser?
Hold his gaze. Your lips might just touch, but not yet. And then you give him one light kiss.
Holy drama llama. Kiss her again.
Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me?
You should totally wear underwear to school.
Got you a present?
Ooh.
I want you to wear them.
I'll be right there.
Dude, those are for ladies.
For y'all, if y'all can get cool, I can hit the boat for y'all.
What? They're breezy, they don't bind, and they give you just enough swing.
Unbelievable.
Sean Tucker must die.
Hasta la vista,
You know, 10? Oh my god, yeah, I used to watch that a lot. I mean, a lot, back in the day. Like, literally, I used to do nothing but watch those shipping AMVs. I'm like, they put a Long Grace character like Sheena with Long Grace Tenzin, like, literally, after playing the game and literally knowing what both they can do, and then literally seeing AMVs of them, I'm like, man, anime is really, really cool. I'm glad, like, this and that. Back in the day, I was like, man, I had no fucking words. I was screaming. I found all those fucking videos. Bootoons are fucking videos that I found, and I put them together. So I used to watch videos like this. You see how that kind of felt like a Bootoons? Like, literally, that's how I used to watch videos. But I put a logo to it and shit like that. And, like, literally, it's orchestrated, but you have to understand, the origin of anime is taking somebody else's shit. Do you know what makes absolutely, you know, like, American television, you know, watchable and viewable for the mainstream audience is because, literally, there's a plot and you have to follow along. It's not just a whole bunch of random shit. And anime gives you excuses to say, what's with the slug? What's with the toad? What's with this and that? Like, literally, why is this hella fucking weird? This is that. Why does this guy have a sword? And why is this fucking this? It just came out, like, literally, it was very easy for fucking me. I'm like, dude, like, they kind of look like normal people, like fucking Dragon Ball Z. Like, some people are fucking green and shit like that, but literally, to me, that's the equivalent of watching fucking Martian and Manhunter and shit, but people don't think like that. People don't think like that. I see the normal people jawlines. I see, like, literally, they still look like they're human, but fucking they can transform and shit. So I look at it as human shit, like we're exaggerated principles. I view Dragon Ball Z shit, like, even back in the day, as human shit, but we're exaggerated principles. Like, literally, I can tell that they're in our space. I can tell that they have superpowers, and the way that this shit is playing out is hella cool. But people don't view it like that. People just view it like, literally, fucking, like, they see the tail instantly instead of looking at the fucking, you know, the muscles. They see the tail. They see everything wrong. Everything that you are not seeing is how people view anime. I'm sorry, but that's why freaking nerds, like, literally, it took it so long to understand. That's why it took a superhero concept for anime to become mainstream instead of the amazing multidimensionality that Dragon Ball Z had, even with the references with Star Wars and shit. Yeah, those two videos blew your fucking mind. Imagine literally watching that while everybody else is watching 300. You know, right then and there, the anime was ahead of its time, but that's the problem you with so much other shit. You have to understand that. You can't always be like that. Like, you can't always, like, turn down, like, because look at the feedback that 300 is getting versus the feedback that literally you're getting by staying inside. And I get feedback now because I recognize concepts like that. But anyway, I used to watch shipping like that all the time. So don't think that I'm not a nerd. Like, full out. I used to watch shit like this when I was younger. And then all of a sudden, fucking, I was in junior high. Oh, Pussy came out. It's just like that. And now all of a sudden, I want to fucking be social and shit like that. And literally, fucking, oh, well, where are you when we're watching 300? You have to think like that. I'm sorry. You have to think like that because that's how you grow up. That's how you literally, you have to admit that you were wrong and then you have to move on. Even though, like, this shit, literally, now that you guys are all in the anime, now that you know the full story, now it's cool, huh? But, like, literally, freaking, you're going to wait for somebody to tell you the full story instead of actually be presentable. So, like, literally, fucking, you can be, like, literally discreet and, like, literally fucking maintain interest on both sides of the parties and shit. You have no idea literally where it comes from. So this is literally just a sample of the life I used to live and why I dropped it, because it is very intellectual, but like I said, you have to understand that you're alone. You have to understand that, like, nothing is contributing to it. You have to understand that literally you are, like, not, you know, staying a life for yourself. You're not giving yourself a complex timeline because you're not allowing, like, events to happen or mysteries to be made or stories to unravel and shit. You figure out what I'm saying over time.